on today's episode of The Supernatural Now.
Great is your love, oh God. And your faithfulness reaches to the sky.
Jesus came to earth to demonstrate the supernatural with miracles, signs, and wonders. Apostle Guillermo Maldonado is called to bring God's supernatural power to this generation. Get ready to receive your miracle today. The Supernatural Now with Apostle Guillermo Maldonado.
Live from the American Airlines Arena, New Wine presents the highly anticipated album, Hunger for the Living God. Get these 12 chart-topping anointed songs written by Apostle Maldonado at New Wine. Experience the presence of God like never before. Order your copy today. Available now at these various sources. Or call 877-286-5585.
Blessing, I'm Apostle Guillermo Maldonado, and this is the program, The Supernatural Now. I want you to be ready to see something, a very special show. And it had to do with New Wine Band. The New Wine Band was born here in the altar. Most of those musicians came into the church. They were not saved. We went out, get them and get them saved. And now they giving their talent to Jesus and they sing for Jesus. So whatever you see here, this music is being played in many nations, translated in many languages. And the reason is because that music is the sound from heaven. Today we have replaced, true worship has been replaced with entertainment. And people come to the church to be entertained, not to worship God. So a lot of the songs, I would say 99% of the songs, came in the altar, in the spirit of the moment, in the sound of the spirit. And you will see how they flow. Those songs came under the anointing, the unction of the Holy Spirit, and most of the time, he came upon me and somebody said, do you sing? No, I don't sing, I sing to God. But I would say that you don't have pastor, you don't have to be a singer to write for God and to minister to God and to worship God. Why? Because the head of the house has the sound of the house. God gives the sound to the pastor. So we give the people the sound. They do the singing, they do the ministering, and we also do it with them. And that's the reason we need to bring those leaders. So whatever you see here, a New Wine Band and King Jesus Ministry, those songs are impacting. And I got testimonies. I was here in Venezuela and the people told me, there was people in the hospitals and they start playing the music and there were people getting up from the beds as they hear the music. And this is continually. Most of the people, they use it to worship in their homes and to enter into the presence of God. Some other people said, no, I put it in my business and I changed the atmosphere. There's some of the things that we need to understand, pastors. If we want the presence of God, this is my recommendation to pastors. I say you need to remove the old atmosphere. What do you mean the old atmosphere? The new cannot come unless you remove the old. And sometimes we stay in the old atmosphere where God is not in it, songs that God is not, the presence and the glory of God is not in those songs anymore. So sometimes it's so hard to get into the presence of God and the people don't experience God. And when we come to church, we must experience the real God. Do you know that in heaven, there's continually a new song and continue. And the Bible says, and they sing a new song. So God is bringing that atmosphere. Pastor, if you want the revival, if you want the move of God like we do here, I mean, and in other churches too, we're not the only one. You need to remove and dismantle the old wineskin, the old atmosphere, and bring the new atmosphere. How do you do it? Well, you bring the new power, the new presence through worship, praise, and worship. So let's watch. This is going to be awesome, and we'll minister to your heart. New Wine Band from King Jesus Ministry. Let's watch.
Thanks, Apostle. Hi, my name is Pastor Melina. I'm the worship pastor here in King Jesus Ministry. And this is my friend James.
Hey, everybody.
And this is Manny. A lot of you may have seen them if you're familiar with the program. And this is just a place where, you know, there's a lot of we've been privileged to kind of like just be in a place where God moves, you know. God is omnipresent, but he just doesn't manifest everywhere, you know. So we've been very privileged to be in this place where God manifests himself. And one of the ways that Apostle has taught us is to kind of like to flow in what he's doing. And due to that, a lot of the songs that that we have here as a worship band in this church kind of like are full or are generated from that atmosphere.
A lot of times with every service that we do, there's always a fresh revelation. Apostle's always looking for, you know, he's always seeking the Lord, getting to know the Lord more, whether it be a supernatural love or power or principles of gratitude and things like that. And because of there's so much revelation, so much movement of God, what we do is put a tool, whether it be a song, a dance, a chant. What we do, praise and worship, we do all that to empower the people to release their faith, to receive the revelation that's coming out of the altar. If Apostle's talking about supernatural love, well, the song that we come out with, whether it be a melody that is inspired by the piano with Manny, a guitar, or even or just a lyric, just something that we hear inside of the. Instead of the preaching, and it just hits our spirit, and all of a sudden we know, we just know that that's part of the song or something like that. We put that in the mouth of the people, and that releases their faith for them to receive what God is doing, and that's how we continue that flow that Apostle was talking about.
I think that helps us stay current too, and stay fresh, because it's always what God is speaking now. Mm-hmm. It's always what God is saying now, and even. From the moment the melody is inspired or the song is inspired, to the moment it comes out, I mean, we don't waste any time. Like, it has to be, everything has to go with the move of the Spirit, because if we take too long in a song, or if we take too long on a series that Apostle's bringing, in 6 months, we could be somewhere else.
Yeah.
So that's why I think, you know, along with James, what James was saying, the revelation and the rhema word of God for that moment or for that time, you know, the moment it goes into praise, it goes into worship, it really brings something fresh to the church, and that's what they need.
Yeah. And I think in some ways, like a lot of people I know, there's this kind of like fear of performance as a worship leader, you know. But I think which is something that you know, Apostle has tackled with us, you know, just to kind of like take risk. But one of the things that you end up seeing is that there's a freedom in it, because whatever you hear, you have to, you just say, you know, and that brings, whether that kind of brings a freedom from kind of like a scheme or a pattern that you see in a lot of places. You know, we've gone to a lot of places, and you know. And we've seen, you know, and not to say anything about different worship bands or anything, but what you tend to see is that the spirit of religion kind of like disguises itself a little bit. And so there's this scheme, like, and this proper pattern of doing things. But when you kind of like flow like this, you know, you get delivered from that. And whatever happens, happens. You know, why don't you take a look? Let's go to one of our favorite songs so that you could experience with us some of what we were talking about.
Up our praises to you, because you are mighty God, and forever your kingdom will stand. In righteousness, truth, and victory, it will prevail. Hey! Mighty power, authority is yours. Mighty
just like a lot of our songs, they come out on the altar, And like you were talking about earlier, Apostle has put this demand on us to constantly be ready to move, you know, to move with the flow of the revelation that's coming to the house. That's something that's consistent and constant. So for instance, there was a 6 p.m. service where one of the newer songs, Jesus is the Name, came out. And I remember it was like right in and out of testimonies, Apostle came. It was a 6 p.m. service, which is supernatural. Apostle always has an idea, but he never has a set schedule or itinerary or agenda. He's always waiting to see what the Spirit wants to do. So in those moments, he kind of also looks towards us to see, all right, let's see what's going on. And for some reason, he looks towards us. He says, "You guys have the new song? You haven't even preached yet." And he goes, "You have the new song?" And like any good son of the house, we have to lift up our thumbs and go like this. Yes, and yeah, we have the song, even though we don't.
By faith,
exactly. And I remember the only thing that he said was, when you speak the name of Jesus, it releases power, So we ended up, he said, "You have the new song?" I think it was Josue Copete, he was on the drums. Yeah. And Manny started doing something with the piano and the strings. And then all of a sudden, you know, "All right, fine, we're gonna do it. I jump up and I go, "Jesus is the name above every name, mighty God. Shout it, and the power of God is released on earth. Anything is possible." It was just like that. It came out like out of nowhere. But suddenly he looked at me, I was like, "Where'd you get it?" I was like, my back pocket. Those are the kind of moments that I think we live for. I think as a band, we're constantly striving to be ready for those moments. Yeah. You know, we listen to the preachings or we pray throughout the week. You know, a lot of the stuff that happens, it's not just on the altar. It's a lifestyle. It's being ready. And Manny can even talk about how that song, which we eventually came back to the piano, us three, and we actually came back and we actually turned it into a full song that becomes an anthem. Yeah. Every time we sing it, we just came back from Venezuela. When we sang it there, a declaration like that really ignites the people. It edifies the faith, and the things that happen there, you know, the miracles that happen testify to the supernatural flow that is occurring on this altar and all around the world.
And going back to that moment on the altar when it came out, now that you said that, we never fully have it all planned out.
No.
We never have the lyrics. I mean, he sang it now like it was easy, but he was there and he had like three words probably, and then the rest just bubbles out. I know they can testify. Yeah, I don't sing, but they lead, and I could tell you 90-95% of the times it's like that. And musically as well, the melody is never fully there. It's just it's like when you're about to prophesy and God shows you something or reveals something to you. It's the same with music. It's the same with worship. It's the same with our praise. We can't just always think that we're gonna have it planned out from the first letter to the last letter, from the first chord to the last chord. It's always to the very last second. It's gonna be spontaneous. So I think that is what we live for, you know. It's a little bit of nervousness, a little bit of butterflies, a little bit of like, "Oh my God, what's gonna happen?" Yeah. And here it is, you know. It's a fully developed song. We, like James said, we took it back and we thought, okay, how can we give this awesome chorus? How can we give it some substance? How can we lead up to it so that it breaks the atmosphere anywhere we go?
Funny, because that's one of the songs that I pray with. People think, you know, I pray with that song because it's one of my husband's favorites, you know, and because it's such an intense declaration. It's a simple declaration. Yeah. It's simple, but it's just an intense, and what it creates, it kind of goes back to that. I remember, I think it was either that Sunday or the Sunday before where we had tag team, and it was all about the name of Jesus, you know, and we actually have other songs that are about the name of Jesus. We didn't develop all of them. But it was just this atmosphere. And I remember that even Apostle said, that was exactly what I wanted to do. And he didn't even tell us that he wanted to preach on that. Do you remember?
Yes. It wasn't until afterwards.
I'm
going to preach about the name of Jesus. And I'm convinced completely that he decided to preach about the name of Jesus once he heard the song come out. He's like, "You know what? That's in the atmosphere. It's in the atmosphere."
It was in the atmosphere, you know, and to this day, I know it just came out, but it's a song that generates so much power. And it's a praise. you know. So it's like I'm home and I'm, you know, and I feel to like war over something. You know, you got to war over your finances. You know, you got to war over things. You got to war over, you know, salvation. And that's the song that I go to, and I have a blast in my personal time with that song. You know, so take a look at another moment with us. You know, I just got a testimony, just yesterday I got a testimony from Mexico that kind of like, it always touches me because what we do without, when we do things for God, we don't do to get something. If we do something for God to try and get something, it's corrupted, it's not genuine. So I, you know, we understand the principles and we understand we attach, you know, when we ask for petitions, and that's great. But when we're on the altar, you know, we just want to worship and to hear the fruit of it. Like yesterday, my husband told me in Mexico, somebody in Mexico, they're not even connected to our church. It was someone had our song playing on their iPad, and an unbeliever walked by and they heard the song and they started to shake and they started to tremble and they started to feel the presence of God. And this person wanted to commit suicide. And they got delivered and they received Jesus. And that to me is so gratifying that I will take a risk at sounding, you know, dumb on an altar. It doesn't matter to me, you know, if we go off key or if we whatever, if we look stupid, I don't care. You know, as long as the end result is somebody's salvation and somebody's deliverance. You know, I don't know if you wanna.
Yeah, I mean, I know that in my life, personally, these songs on the altar or off the altar, they've ministered to me. My time of prayer with God, I like to actually play the songs. You know, I thank God for that I can, but I like to just sit on my keyboard and I'll just be there. I'll shut off the lights and I'll play any of our songs. And the atmosphere, and I feel the presence of God as I say this, but the atmosphere in whatever room I'm in will completely change, and it's not because of me, but it's like what Pastora was saying, the spirit is attached to that song. Whatever happened at that moment, whatever was the atmosphere in CAP, in the nations, in the house, it's there, it's attached. And whether it's just the melody or whether it's just the song or whether it's the lyrics, whatever it is, it ministers to your heart. I'll just play, and I'll play for half an hour, I'll play for an hour, I'll play for 2 hours. I may never sing, but that the message of the song, the message, the spirit that's there is attached to the song, and it'll release it anywhere. Mm-hmm. Anywhere you go, anywhere you play, you sing.
I feel led to do this because there's an essential need for everyone, and that's the need of God. And whatever your need is that you may be watching right now, He can fulfill it. That's one of the most powerful revelations that I've gotten, that once the presence of God, and I feel the presence of God as we're speaking, so once the presence of God enters a room, you know, you need to take advantage of it. So I feel that there's a lot of people that may be watching that, you know, you're watching this program on worship, and you know, you usually maybe tune in to watch apostles speak, you know, and there's a lot of people that have a need. You have a physical need in your body, you know, and God is just that good. He will supply that need. Yeah. Whatever it is that you may be lacking, be it in your body, being with an infirmity, being with something, maybe I feel things in the lungs area actually right now. I feel like problems in the lungs that are being healed right now. Amen. And that's the goodness of God. Every time that you speak on what He's done, and that's why whenever, you know, I can speak on what happens on this altar with these songs, I do it because they're God-driven, you know, and God is in them. So since we're speaking about that, God is here, and I can feel Him. He's providing healing for you right now. There's actually people that are, I don't know if you're bed stricken, but I see you're almost incapacitated to move. And the God of the impossible, this Jesus that we were talking about, He heals you. And yes, right now, I pray that wherever you're at, His presence overwhelms you and He brings healing to you, because there's healing in Jesus' name. And actually right now, Father, let your healing power come. And that everything you did for your sons and your daughters and humanity, not just your sons and daughters, but humanity, you did it all for us on the cross. Let everything that you've done on the cross be manifested right now. Healing, there's healing power, there's deliverance right now, there's salvation. There's a lot of people that have mental issues and anxiety right now. The devil of anxiety and depression, the spirit of depression that moves in the airs of this world cannot touch you. And I declare that the peace of God, the peace of God that surpasses all understanding, may flood everyone's mind and soul at this very moment. And with that, Father, right now, I declare that your presence overtakes and overshadows everything that surrounds them, and every worry and care from this world leaves them now. We declare healing, peace, nothing missing and nothing broken. That is the covenant we have with you. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Now, I believe that you can continue to receive, because right now we're gonna go to our annual conference. And it was a wonderful place because we had 18,000 people worshiping along with us. And we've gotten testimonies of deliverance. And we actually heard it while we were doing the CD. You know, we actually heard people getting delivered. So if you're there, and you need deliverance, and you're in a place of, you know, depression, of despair right now, let this worship minister to you, and that the atmosphere that was there with these 18,000 people and this just manifestation of the power of God, that it flood the place that where you're at right now. So I pray that you receive the fullness of God, because He's here to provide that for us. So God bless.
Know your name.
Live from the American Airlines Arena, New Wine presents the highly anticipated album, Hunger for the Living God. Get these 12 chart-topping anointed songs written by Apostle Maldonado at New Wine. Experience the presence of God like never before. Order your copy today. Available now at these various sources. Or call 877-286-5585.
Thank you for watching today's program and for making this worldwide ministry possible. With your support, this generation is being impacted by the supernatural power of God. The previous program was paid for by the friends and partners of Apostle Guillermo Maldonado and King Jesus International Ministry.